¿Cómo están? Good morning, everybody. Today is the first day of remote learning, and I really miss you guys. I've missed, like, being in school and teaching you guys in real life, but I made a video for you to learn all about today's lesson, which is the present progressive. Here we go. Hey, rebels. Welcome to Spanish class. All right, your first question might be, what is the present progressive? Good question. We have the present progressive in English as well. In English, the present progressive is whenever a word ends in ing, right? So, for example, that could be, I am swimming. You are talking. We are writing. That ing at the end of the word makes it present progressive. It's what's progressing presently, what's happening right now. So if I were to use the present progressive right now, I would say right now I am talking. That's what I'm doing. What are you doing right now? Well, you are listening, hopefully. So that ing form in English is present progressive. We need to do it now in Spanish. So if the first step in forming the present progressive in Spanish has to do with the verb estar. So I'm going to give a real quick review of the verb estar. Here we go. Here are our endings for estar. The yo form is estoy, which means I am. Tu form is estás, which means you are. El, ella, and usted form is está, which is he is, she is, you are, or it is. Nosotros form is estamos, we are. Vosotros form is estáis, y'all are. And the ellos, ellas, ustedes form is están, which is they are or y'all are.
So in English, estar means to be. But in English, we don't use be very often. We don't say, I be at home, you be at home, we be at home. We say, I am at home. Whenever we're using the verb estar in English, we're usually just saying am, are, or is. Those three words in English often translate to the verb estar in Spanish. Now, so far we've learned a couple uses of estar. Remember when we used estar to talk about location? Let's do a quick review.
Yo estoy debajo de la mesa.
El marcador está encima del libro.
The marker is on top of the book.
Las plumas están adentro de la mochila.
The pens are inside the backpack.
Perfect. So in those examples that you just saw, you saw that the word, the different conjugations for the verb estar could either be am, are, or is. Now, we use that in talking about location, but we can also use the verb estar to talk about what we're doing. We do this all of the time in English with verbs that end in ing. Let me give you some examples. Alright, here are some example sentences of the present progressive in English. Remember, present progressive is what's happening, what's progressing presently. So some examples of that would be, I am eating, and that would be our form of a star. You are swimming. Are is our form of a star. We are studying. Are is our form of a star. And he is writing. Is our form of a star.
I hope you guys noticed that every single one of these sentences has a word that ends in ing. Swimming, eating, studying, writing. So now we just need to know how to form this ing ending in Spanish. And it's actually fairly easy. Here we go. If a verb is an AR verb, then to make the ing form, participle are these words? Reading, swimming, studying. Right. In English, the present participle ends in I and D. In Spanish, you form the present participle. Hablando is the present participle of the word hablar. Pretty easy, right? Now, if it is an ER or an IR verb, it's a little bit different. Instead of A-N-D-O, the ending is I-E-N-D-O. Ando? Yendo. So, a word that ends in ER or IR, a good example could be distancier. Remember the verb distancier means to be stuck. Distancier means to discuss. I take off that IR ending, and instead of IR, I put I-E-N-D-O. So that would be discutiendo would mean discussing. So discutiendo is the present participle of discutir. So now you know everything you need to know to write these sentences in Spanish. Let's try it. Let me get my fancy blue marker. You are swimming. Next one, we are studying. We is nosotros. Remember, we the present participle. Last one. He is writing. He is L. Is, we need the L form of estar. So that would be está. L está. Writing is escribir.
lesson in order to do the work for today. I also included some documents in the email and on Google Classroom that will help you. There's some notes on this that I wrote out for you if this didn't quite make sense and some practice for you to do. I also included all the conjugations of a star and a sheet that reminds you what all these verbs are in case you can't remember what some of them are. So look at all of those resources, and I hope you guys have a great first week of remote learning. I miss you. Please send me an email if you have any questions. Stay home.